and everything. Then we will plan. What about something happened to you? Jim, you have a little baby? What about something happened to you? Let's say you die. Who's going to raise your baby? You want your sister to raise your baby? Great. But when you don't plan well, your grandma, you know, will have a right to choose. No, you know what I mean, right? So all these things, you can plan. We will show you how to do it. So we're totally focusing on helping your people, helping our people out there, teaching this basic concept with all this blue book. And also when they come in here, there's a workshops, workbooks, and teach you all the basic stuff about financial, you know, information. Now I'm gonna give you some more information, a little bit of information, but this current situation right now, in the United States, there's only 5 states in this country has some kind of a requirement, some kind of a study materials for the high school children about how money works. 5 out of 50. Right. Funny thing is, they teach our children all the sex, about sex, 22 states plus high school in Colombia. I'm not saying sex is not that important. I'm talking about it is important. But something's wrong there. We should teach our children about how money works for us too. What does our school teach our children? They teach our children how to become a good employee. When they go to college, you know, they'll be so happy they got a free shirt with a big MasterCard logo on it. And they even got the card. Cannot have a big credit limit, it's like $500, but they teach our children spend the money they don't even have. Yeah. Something's going wrong here. And somebody needs to do something about it. And that's what we decided to commit it anyway. Now look at this. Financial literacy can really help. High school students who receive the personal financial education are able to. These are the students who learn about financial stuff. They could manage their money better, and they could have the fewer maxed out credit cards. They could have a higher savings, higher rate of savings, and they could compare and do the better shopping, and they pay the debt on time, so they don't have to worry about high interest, you know, the payment they make it. Okay, and funny thing is, between age 30 and 49, they achieve significantly higher savings and net worth compared to other kids who didn't have that education. Do you think the little class about money is not important? It'll make a big difference at the end. Age 30 and 40 will make a big difference. That's why you have to teach all this concept to your. Now, let me give you, so this is our example that we do here. This is a crisis that we have. Biggest crisis that we have right now. All of us, you know, problem with these 3 main crises out there. First one is a retirement crisis. Okay. Before we used to depend on government. They have a program for Social Security. And the Social Security will pay for you until you die, pretty much, right? But Social Security started in 1935. At that time, average person died at age 63. And here now, 2018, if you're age 63, you could get married 2 more times. It's a totally different generation. It was started because of, at the time, the depression time, the young generation don't have a job. So they kind of encourage older people to retire so younger generation can have a job. That was the main sources. And we don't have that much problem because everybody died at age 63. Big problem. Now, or company pension pay for our retirement too. But nobody, I don't think any Fortune 500 company will have a, you know, the pension plan right now. Unless you go to US Army or something. Yeah, your company give you 401k. Just check out Blue Book. I mean, 401k is a defined contribution plan which you pay for it. I'm talking about defined benefit plan. You work for a company, you qualify, they'll give you money until you die. You know, whatever percentage you're supposed to earn. That's part of my pension anyway. And also, education is another crisis, and spending is another crisis. I'm gonna probably get into that a little bit, but let's talk about retirement first too here. I just wanna show you this. This one is announced in July 2017, last year, okay? It's not me announced it. It's not a Time magazine. It's not a Filipino local newspaper in Las Vegas. It's a Social Security Trustees announced it. July 13th, check there, it's publicly, you can check it anyway. It says, trust funds backing the payment of Social Security benefits would be what? Would be zero in what year?
2035.
So how many more years? 17 more years.
Yeah.
And funny thing is, this is not kind of funny. After that, it's kind of funny. It says, a zero trust fund does not mean, it does not mean the payment of the Social Security benefit would be zero, but rather, what? Rather it dropped to?
77%.
So you supposed to get $2,000 every month. Boom, one day, you only get $400. Can you survive?
No. Might as well die.
We didn't have any more money there.
What about disability insurance? What about Medicare? Medicare, same report says Medicare Part A is the most important one, right? Because Part A will pay for your hospital, okay?
Yeah.
And they projected the fund will be totally depleted at 2029, okay. Even 6 years before Social Security problem. And I was surprised about it. That's why I checked their report, and this is actually their graph here. Mm-hmm. By the time you're 2034, it is zero. And after that, you go under. It is from Social Security Trustees report in July. It is crazy. And funny thing is, your grandma and my grandma are heavily depending on Social Security right now.
Mm-hmm.
One third of our retirees right now are depending on Social Security.
Yeah.
Can you imagine? You are 95 years old. You wish you were dead. We're not. You're supposed to have $1,000 to survive.
Uh-huh.
Boom, one day, you only give you $300. Can you survive? You can't even afford the Big Mac. So, big challenge is going on. Retirement is the biggest crisis that we're expecting. What about college? Look at this. College is part of American dream. It should be part of what? Part of financial nightmare for the family. College planning is like crazy out there. When you take a look at it, these are the schools most expensive in Columbia University. It's about $57,000 tuition a year. Not for 4 years, a year. And look at all this. USC, another $54,000. But plus room and board, plus other expenses, plus the entertainment. Oh, trust me, I have a son who goes to, you know, this private college, it does cost you a lot too, you know? So, what do we do? We have we found I think the Philly mentioned about it, it's 503C, the nonprofit from the federal level, okay, USA, Canada. We found a company called the nonprofit organization called HIPA. They do college coaching program, and they do all this thing, and now let me just like, look at this. National average amount of financial aid awarded per student is about $14,460. In this program, whoever went to this program, average person will get about almost like triple, $34,000. And 65% of the average person will get this financial stuff, almost like 95%. So we using this school to helping your children, my children, helping all this. They do personal coaching about college planning and everything too, including all the scholarship and all those things too. So that's what we do. We connect the nonprofit organizations who provide these services, connect with the people who need those services. You have children, you want to send them a good school, you want to find a good some kind of a financial plan together. Why don't you connect with this school, and you could be your own agent too. And also, this one talk about spending. This is my favorite line that this guy did. He said, too many people spend money they even haven't earned to buy, they don't even want. to impress people they don't even like. That's what we spend. That's what this is happening. Spending crisis are the biggest one. I know this might give you headaches, but poor USA, the biggest problem right now, we thought it was about $61 trillion only. But there's a money shortage of Medicare and Social Security combined together. Overall, we have about $129 trillion in debt. We only thought it was only half of it. And still we feel bad. But actually, because of all this money, Medicare, the money is not there. And it's over 129, which means one per each person living in this country. We have over 300 million population here. Baby to 900 years old man, doesn't matter. Average person has about 400,000 debt. I'm a family of five, 400,000 per person, which means $2 million debt in our family. That's what's happening out there. And we are part of it. If you're lucky, you'll be okay. But guess what? Your children will be responsible for this. This will be there. So again, retirement, education, spending, all these problems. Is there any solution we can solve these guys out? And bottom line is, there's a solution. We gotta help them to build the financial foundation. We'll teach them all this concept. Just like building a house out there. We build it from the ground up, having a proper protection to have a debt management, reduce your debt, have an emergency fund, have a long-term savings investment for your children's education, for your retirement. This is a solution. Find out what do you have right now, and we'll get your goal, we'll set your goal, help you to have your goal. Some people don't even have a goal. They don't even think about they don't even know how much money they need for their retirement. Yeah. We'll help you to set your goal and try to find a way to fulfill or hit your goals. And that's what we're trying to do. So we'll give you a solution. Now, before we go in, I want to give you some basic concept about financials. I know some of you have been around for a while. You understand about all this. But basic concept for Rule of 72. Okay? Very simple. A very simple mathematical rule. Okay? It will show you power of compounding interest rate. Let's say you go to bank and get about 4% interest rate. How does Rule of 72 works? Just take the 72, divide by interest rate that you're getting. So what's the 72 divided by 4? 18. That's how long it will take, your money will be doubled. So let's say you are age 29, you have $10,000. You go to Bank of America, get about 4% interest rate. You live there, then you get an interest, after interest called compound interest. How long you take for your money, 10,000 will be 20,000? About 18 years later. Around 18 years later, when you reach 65, you will have a 40,000. You got 4%, 40,000. What about same amount of money at same time, 29, 10,000, this time you're getting 8%. 4%, 40,000. 8%, 80,000, but it doesn't work that way. Same concept. 72 divided by 8 is 9. Every 9 year, money will be double. By the time you're reaching 65, you'll have about $160,000. Money is a lot more than double. Interest is only double, money is a lot more.
26.
What about you getting a 12%? Same money, 28, 29 years old, same 10,000, and every 6 year, your money will be double, okay? So 35, 41, 47, by the time you reach 65, you'll have a $640,000. Now, this is something they need to understand. When we go to bank with interest, we save money for our retirement for long term, they don't even give me a 4%. But let's say they did give me a 4%. And then what do? They turn this money around and give me a credit card, and they charge how much?
35.
20% or 18%. They give me a loan when they buy a car. When I'm buying a car, give me 6, 7, 8%. So they used to make about 12%. So they are the one who's making money out of my money anyway. So what happened? With my 10,000, they make it about 600,000. And they give me a 40,000 back when I retire. And guess how much money they keep?
Yes.
600,000 with my money. You know what that means? That means about 30,000, 20 years worth of money is there. The other one's making, but they understand this concept. Look at this. This is very scary. I read this one, still hang out. It's Albert Einstein. He said, compounding interest is the eighth wonder of the world. Not that many people understand about that power of it. And look at this. He who understands it owns it. And he who doesn't, guess what?
Pays it.
Do you understand this concept? You could earn it. You don't, you pay for it. And this is another, if you understand this concept today, I think you're going to wake up now. It's working for you to be here. This is how you build wealth. For you to bake the cake, there's a recipe. For you to build the wealth, there's a recipe too. Okay, so this is what we call wealth formula. First, you're going to find some money called save money. Make more, spend less. That's your problem. You got to find some money. And after that, understand the power of time. Which means try to keep it for a long time. The longer, the better, has a more power on it. And try to get a higher rate of return. Always minus inflation, minus tax is called wealth. What does that mean? That means minimum 5%. You don't get 5% from anywhere else, you're losing your game. Why? Last but 100 years in this country, inflation is about 3%, a little over 3%. You gotta pay about 30, 40% tax. So you should get at least 5%. That's a 30% out of 5, 1.5 deducted. You only have a 3.5 left to compete with inflation. So if you're getting less than 6% or 5%, you're losing it. Which means your grandma put the money under the pillow, under the mattress, which means you're losing minimum 3% with inflation. So it's important for you to know it. So money, you gotta come up with some kind of money. Save, you know, make more, spend less. But I couldn't understand why time comes after. I really couldn't understand why time comes after. And this example will show you exactly the power of time. And that's what people don't understand. But this is a story. When you study real estate, this story comes out always, because this is the best way, best example of investment in real estate. Yeah. By square footage wise, the most expensive area right now is still Manhattan,
yes.
New Manhattan. Mm-hmm. The guy who owns a couple buildings in that area becomes president now. Okay. Anyway, now if you have a 2-3 bedroom condominium facing in Central Park, there's a small window. That's over double-digit million in that time. That's how expensive that is. They said more than $60 billion today for real estate of Manhattan Island, small island, looks like a New York State. It's about $60 billion. But guess what? In 1626, this guy named Peter Minuit, he's the one of the controlling governor at that time, he bought this Manhattan Island from Manahata Indian. Okay, that's why they got named Manhattan. How much? $24. And he didn't even pay cash. He gave him a blanket, clothes, and trinkets. And $24. And it becomes $60 billion plus today. It's one of the best real estate investments in the history of mankind. Right? But guess what? What if this guy with this money, he didn't buy Manhattan, he comes to Philip Boyle. And Philip Boyle showed him how to get about 10% return. Let's say 10%. And it's about 390 years later today, how much money will be? 1,000, million, billion, trillion. Today, it'll be about $333 trillion. $60 billion is right here, $60 billion. So with this money, you could buy a whole Manhattan again with a $60 billion, still there's a three, whatever left. What they could do? They could buy all real estate in all USA. And still there's money left over. With that money, they could buy a whole Europe and still there's money left. They could buy a whole earth, still there's money left. Why? It's because of long years. It's a part of long years. So when you think about investment, always the longer the better. Always understand it may take some time. So if you think about, can you imagine you save about $100 for 40 years? That money, $48,000 would be over $1 million. So if your mom and dad do that for you, teach you that concept, and you didn't know better, just keep on doing it after you get your first job. By the time you become age 40, you have $1 million. Think about that. If you keep it up until age 65, you'll have $17 million. You have age 65, you have $17 million, come to us. We'll show you how to get a 5% interest until you die, rest of your life. What's the 5% of 17 million? 850,000 a year, every year. Which means, that means you could get married every year. And when you die, 17 million plus interest will go to your next generation. And do you understand? $100. Don't tell me your father don't have $100. Don't tell me your grandfather didn't have $100. If your grandfather did $100 to your mom and dad, and your mom and dad didn't know better, they just work hard, keep on saving $100. By the time they're reaching age 65, boom, 70 million. If your mom and dad has a 70 million today, do you think their life could have been changed?
Yes. Yes.
Do you think your life could have been changed?
Yes.
Do you think your children's life could have been changed?
Yes.
It could have been changed. But guess what? They don't have, I know you don't have 70 million. It's not because you're so poor. It's because of what? Because you didn't know how it works. How come they didn't know how it works? Is John Lewis the only one who's smart enough to know all this? No. There's people who's licensed at the time knew this formula and everything too. But where were they? They were always busy to helping the people up there with the lots of money, not your grandma and my grandma. If they help my grandma to do it, my mom is age 87, 86 right now. If she's about $25 million, man, my life could be totally changed. Yes, it takes a long time, but trust me, sooner or later, you'll be 65. Sooner or later, you'll be 85.
Yeah.
The bottom line is, save some money and do it for your children and teach your children. My goal is, whoever is over 40 years old should have $1 million+. All you need to do is save $100 a month. Make sure to do it for your children. Thank God, I started business about 26 years ago when I have a brand new one baby. And that's what I do to my little ones now. They're not that little anymore. They got their job now. I'm teaching them. They save their own money. They all have to keep it up. By the time they become my age, they should have a minimum double digit. Mm-hmm. Why? That's how money works. Mm-hmm. Why? I understand the concept. Why? I'm teaching them the concept. It's not how much money that you make. Everybody can make money. But not that many people can understand about how they could build the wealth. How they cook the wealth. You want to cook the turkey? There's a recipe. This is how you cook the wealth. There's a recipe for this. So find some money, $100. If $100 is too much, $10.
Right.
You're not going to have a 17 million at age 65. You have a 1.7 by doing 10. Long time. Fight for the rate of returns, but always understand minus inflation and minus tax. So they, wealthy people knew just a little bit. They just utilized those concepts generation after generation. That's why they got wealthier and wealthier. Okay, so that's what we try to do. That's our mission anyway. I'll show you this. This will blow your mind away. Same example. You save $100 a month, getting a 12% interest rate. Okay? This is only example anyway. And our goal is, by saving $100, $1 million at age 65. You want to become a millionaire at age 65. In case one, three ways possible. Say from age 26. Tell me you could start to make some money at age 26.
Yes.
Okay? You save $100 a month until you retire at age 65. If your children cannot do it, you do it for your children. And how much money? $48,000. By the time you have over $1 million with the 12% return. Yes, you gotta pay tax for it and everything, but just get the concept here. Okay? Now, second one is a little bit different. So first one is 4 years, right? 4 years. Second one is a little bit different. You starting early, but not you. Probably mom and dad needs to understand. Saving early, age 18, 100,000 a month, until 25, 8 years. And no more, no more. Only 8 years. How much money did you save it? 9,600. And leave it there, let it grow. Compound interest rate works. Rule of 72, 2%, 6 years. You only save 9,600. How much money you have? You have $1.5 million. Half million more than this. You know that? That's how money works. Oh my gosh, I didn't know. That's why I want to teach you. That's why you need money. That's how wealthy people knew for a long time. We worked so hard. We went to good school, good nursing school, become a nurse, working so hard. We work for money. It's important for you to understand this concept. Have your money working for you instead. And number three will blow your mind. I told you, I mean, this time, and I was in Canada having a meeting, we called the ambulance. The one lady almost lost a baby. One guy had a heart condition. He had a really heart attack. It's so shocking here. So if you have any heart condition, do not listen to me. Prevalent? Okay, don't listen to me. Number three. You save $100,000 for only 1 year. How much is total saving? $1,200. Leave it there, let it grow. How much money you'll have? You'll have about $1.9 million. Just for 1 year. It takes 65 years. Yes, it looks kind of long, but trust me, time will go by. Right, Marlene? You still think that you are, like, just finished your high school, but still. Now, number four is what I really want you to do. That's what wealthy people do. When they have a brand new one baby, when you have a brand new one baby, just save $100. By the time brand new one baby get a job, start to make some money, have them keep it up until age 65. So total savings is about $78,000 total. It's $100 each. How much money do you have? You have $70,000. Oh, it doesn't look that way. Yes, it does. That's what rich and wealthy people do. Okay, so again, that's wealth formula, and people need to understand. Now, when you build the wealth, also this one, you gotta also plan well to preserve your estate too when something happens to you. Elvis Presley, your favorite, right? We hear about $10 million at the time. When he died, his family has to pay about $7 million tax. They only keep less than, so 72%. Marilyn Monroe, oh my gosh, she had about $819,000. A lot less than what I expected, you know, but she worked so hard to make money. More than half. That means if you have a lot of money, you gotta also make sure you understand how money works, under how tax works against you, and prepare for it. Do we know the way? Yes. It's not us. We know the company who does those jobs for you for less than $500. Plan for that. If I wish Elvis is still alive, I could say, hey, give me about $495. I'll connect you to the company called Legacy Shield. They'll save your butt. They save you $7 million, man.
Yeah.
He was like, thank you very much. This is my money. This guy, Robert Kiyosaki, I think, his book is kind of very basic. But anyway, I should give him a credit because he's one of the few guys, one of the pioneers to talk about this financial literacy about this country anyway. He said academic qualifications are important, so is financial education.
Absolutely.
Agree, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
They're both important. And screw up forgetting one of them.
Yeah.
Guess what that is, right? If you want to be rich, you need to be financially literate. That's what he said.
Mm-hmm.
And now, this is my favorite. It's not how much money you make, but how much money you keep, and people thought that's it, that's not it. How much money you keep, how hard it works for you. So money you keep, let it work hard, work for you,
mm-hmm.
and guess what? And how many generations you keep it for.
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
That's what Robert Kiyosaki said. It's not how much money that you make. It's how much money you keep, and how hard it works for you, and how many generations you keep before. That's what Robert Kiyosaki said. He said, ignorance is the mother of the problem. He's an Indian philosopher. And other Alan Greenspan, and he's retired, but still, you know, his influence is still strong right now. But number one problem in today's generation is what? Is?
Financial.
It's lack of financial literacy.
Yeah.
People don't understand how money works anymore. An investment in knowledge always pays the best interest. That's what one of our founding father, Benjamin Franklin, said. And this is my favorite too. Warren Buffett. It's in our, you know, it's philosophy of our FFIO product. Okay? He only have a, again, the one of the investment guru, Warren Buffett, said, I have only two rules. Rule number one, never lose money. Rule number two, never forget rule number one.
Yes.
That means you gotta invest, but make sure you keep the safety too. And the same thing, this is what he said. Do not, it's in our blue book anyway, do not save what is left after spending. You're not gonna find one anyway, right? But spend what is left after
saving.
That's not what Warren Buffett said. And this is my favorite. This does have extra meaning too. Predicting rain doesn't count. Building arcs does. Do you know rain's coming? You know there's a crisis on your retirement. You have a baby? Yeah, man, there's a crisis on education. There's a crisis on our spending too. Make sure you build something. Make sure you plan something for it. Don't just worry about it. Everybody can worry about it. But do something now. That's what it means. That is our philosophy of our financial campaign. This is very strong. One of the third. If you are born poor, it's not your mistake. It's your mom and dad's mistake. Okay? It's not your mistake. But if you die poor, guess what?
It's
yours. We put this advertisement in a magazine. This is our WFG advertisement that we put on the financial campaign.
I love Starbucks.
Spending versus saving. Spending $10 a day buys you about 2.5 cup of lattes. But save about $10 a day for 30 years with 8% interest rate will give you almost like what? About half a year. This amount is in our blue book anyway. That's what we do in our campaign, World Financial Group. So that's what we do. What do? We're building people a financial foundation. And again, financial security is not a dream, it's a simple priority. You just have to set it and help them out. And that's basically who we are and what we do. Again, this is a foundation that we'd like to build for you. Just like building a house from the ground up, we want to build a protection, debt management, emergency fund, and investment. That's what WFG is all about. That's what we are. Okay, so this is a basic concept of truly who we are and what we do here. I know we got lots of products and lots of services out there. I just want you to know just basics here, because it is kind of little bit complicated too, because since we have so many different products and services available, this is our platform. Whatever we do, give people hope and dream, any protection insurance program, any saving and investment, and help people to be somebody. Debt management, estate preservation, education, retirement, even travel the world. By the way, next week we go to Taiwan and Vietnam for annual big super trip.
Yes.
Yep. 4,000 people.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And also next year, last year we went to Italy, Rome, and Florence.
Yep.
The year before we are in Korea and Japan.
Yep.
The year before we are in Spain. Again, in Spain we have 6,000 people.
Yep.
Year before, we had a Singapore and Thailand. Mm-hmm. And that's the time that I have a chance to ride an elephant, right? I mean, we go to see the world out there. In July, when you go to convention, we're going to announce a new trip, super trip, to go somewhere very far away. Mm-hmm. Somewhere that you really need to go.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to say, it's supposed to be a surprise. When you go and see the pyramid. Okay, so you better go. So anyway, but that's the platform. Whatever service that we do here, we're gonna get them in. That's what we do. Now this year we start doing a tax reporting service, CPA service pretty much. So any of your clients need somebody, okay? Jeremy, now, if any of your friends need a CPA, hey, connect with our services.
Right.
When you go to HR block, they're not CPA. It's like part-time, just get trained to do tax filing. That's what they do it for you. Actual CPAs are doing it for you. You don't have to see them. Everything we do it through virtually could be done. Now, California and Georgia and Florida, very soon, we're starting a real estate too.
Wow.
So everything that, you know, this platform that we do here. But if you don't mind, I just want to show you. I just want to show you one single product, and I want to show you how simple that is. Okay, called Fantastic Four Steps to Close the Deal. Just simple. I just want to show you briefly. Okay. That's what we call it. Fantastic Four Steps. Simple steps. Can somebody has a blue book? No? Can I buy your blue book? Who has a blue book? Yes, please. Okay, I'll just go. Thank you. We have a, when we sit down with a potential client, we just put this 1, 2, 3, 4 simple step. That's how we market the products. Okay? Marlon, so do not complicate. Simple things, right? Number one, when you sit down with the clients, just get the client's information first. We call it PFS or FNA. PSA stands for Personal Financial Strategy. Pretty much find out what's their current situation. Picture of their current financial situation. How much money they make, what's the spending, where the money goes and everything, okay? So that's number one. When you fill up the form, you sit down with the Philip Boyles, we're gonna come up with a basic proposal. And which we're doing it for you together. We're not gonna let you do it. Some people say, John, I don't have experience of 25 years. Don't worry about it. 26 years experience will help you to do this form for you. You got the client information, we got the proposal, then you study, and you sit down with the clients, you show this book, and read this book together with your clients. So that's how we put the sales. You don't need to know anything special. Very simple. Page 24, 46, 76, okay? So page 24. Mr. Clients, I got your information. Now I have a proposal, I'd like to show it to you. But before I do, let me share a couple concepts with you. Now, this is what we call Blue Book. We teach people about this concept here. Page 24 talk about X-curve. There's a two important law that you need to understand. Law of decreasing responsibility and law of building wealth. One goes down when the other one goes up. Everybody has this much of responsibility, everybody. You could reduce your responsibility by building a wealth. So when you are younger I should say, you don't have that much capital, that much wealth that you build up, so your responsibility is so high. So in that case, you gotta take care of your family when something happened to you. While you're working hard building a wealth, by the time you build enough wealth, you are self-insured. When you get visually older, that's what, in that case, you have to take care of your future. So our goal is, Mr. Christ, reduce your responsibility by building a wealth. That's what we call X-curve concept. Please don't understand this concept. That's page 24. Next page is 46. The proposal that I'd like to show it to you, Mr. Clients, is something called FFIL Basic Products. It has a great features of tax advantage. When you invest the money here, first, you get a tax-free death benefit. It is life insurance policy. When your mom and dad died, you got a benefit, no tax, no income tax. That's why it's tax-free. Now, you can also save the money within that policy. While money's growing, no tax. So tax deferred earnings. When you need the money, up to a principal, you could take out as a withdrawal called tax-free withdrawal. No tax, no income tax. And when you need a lot more than that, you could use it as a loan. Since it's a loan, no tax. It has a great tax advantage too. Last one is page 76. By the way, this one talks about all the great information. You know? It talks about when you have a brand newborn baby, you raise the baby to about 18 years old, it costs you about $250,000. And then when they go to college, this is a tuition for the next 18 years, You go to private, that's about 312,000. You go to public, that's about 100 grand. Anyway, all this great information is here, but page 76. Mr. Clients, I want to show you about concept of managed growth. Just like Warren Buffett said, rule number one, never lose money. Growth is important, but you never lose money. When you think about investment or saving money, understand this managed growth, which is a four cornerstone. Your money has to grow. It has to be saved. Make sure you have a tax advantage. At the same time, make sure you have a protection too at the same time. Protection means insurance. Now, if you think about Filipino, I know you like to invest money into real estate. Can real estate grow?
Yes.
Are you sure?
No.
You could, you may not.
Risk.
That's why it could be safe, it may not. Oh yeah, if you're in Philippines, small island, you buy a piece of land, you gotta grow, but not in here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If you think this is a Philippine, you're Takanaga. So it has to be grown. What about tax advantage? Buy a house, take the tax advantage? No. What about protection, insurance? No. House will protect you from the rain, but not from the insurance. So real estate, not even here, one yes.
Yeah.
What about you go to investment to stock market? Can it grow?
Maybe.
Yes, maybe. What about safe? No.
No.
Tax advantage? No.
No.
Protection? No.
No.
What about you go to Bank of America? Can it grow? No.
No.
Can it safe?
Yes.
Yeah. But it's not safe because that's inflation. Tax advantage? No.
No.
Protection? No.
No.
What if I show you the way it grow up to 15%? Safe. Minimum 0.75 guarantee. Tax-free loan, tax-free withdrawal, tax-free death benefit. And yes, it's a life insurance too. And also including long-term care. This is called managed growth too. So that's on page 76. And the page 78 talk about formula 10 and 20. Very simple. For you to plan for your life insurance, minimum 10 times of your income. If you make $50,000, you gotta have a minimum $500,000 life insurance. If you think about retirement, make sure minimum 20 times. It's gotta be 22 times, but we simplify it as a 20 times. You have $50,000 income, you gotta have a minimum $1 million saved up to keep your maintain your lifestyle. That's what it means, formula 10 and 20. So keep that in your mind, Mr. Clients, and let me show you your actual proposal. Four different scenarios. I know it gives you a little bit of headache, but anyway, it could be very fun and simple. Now, you are 30 years old, young male, very healthy, and will get you long-term care and $500,000 insurance coverage, and you save about $500,000 a month, okay? $500,000 sounds a lot, but for your retirement, anyway, just hear me out first, see what you say later. Now, since you pay $500 a month, it's $6,000 a year. Mm-hmm. 5, 10, 15 year plus. This is your total payment. 5 years, $30,000. 10 years, $60,000. This is your cash value. This is necessary the value which you could use the money. And when something happened to you, you die, this is what happened. So 80-15, you save about $90,000 total. Not 15 years later, right? Your value went up to 114. If you die, half million plus 114, 614 will pay to you and your beneficiary. Okay? You keep it up until you retire age 65. So age 65, you pay. How much is total payment? 210,000. And by the time your value went up to about 641,000 with a 7.7 5% average. What's the actual they did last 20 years? 8.65. 1% make a big difference, definitely more than double. But anyway, let's say it's about 641,000. Actually, it's more than double. Okay? Now, what happened here after that? No more pay. Your total payment is 210. You're getting about $42,000 out every year for your income. Your social security. Now what does this mean? This means your total payment. Out of 210 that you pay, you take out 42,000, then it's 167 left, right? That will show you how much money you pay. Now, Charlie, what's my minus? That means this much more than what you pay for in using it. So you pay $6,000, $500 until you retire, next 35 years, until you're 65, you're taking out $42,000 for next about several years, pretty much, until age 91. So how much money did you take out? $882,000 more than what you paid for. How much money did you pay?
$210,000.
And you got paid more than that. Okay, so this will show you, even though you save $500 a month, and you get paid almost, like you could get about almost like $4,000 monthly out. Little less than $4,000 out. So $882,000 more than what you pay for. That's what this thing is about. Okay? And also long-term care. Also, this one is another scenario. Same thing here. At age 65, stop. How much money did you pay? $210 total, right?
Yeah.
And you take $42,000. After 5 years, start from 71, you qualify to get a long-term care. Long-term care means, it's not a health insurance. Long-term care means, out of six daily, basic daily activity, okay? B, C, D, E, T, T. What's the B stands for?
Bathing,
which is a real problem. When you're age 95, I know some of you are laughing and some of you, you know, complain about, John, you're so funny, you almost make me cry. I said, great. If you're laughing so much, you cry, that means you're still young. When you get old, you cry tomorrow. So B stands for bathing. What about C?
Clothing.
Continence. D? D?
Dressing.
E?
Eating.
Eating. T?
Toileting.
Another T? Transferring from your wheelchair to bed. So we are 95, you're 85, can you walk straight? Can you go to the bathroom by yourself? You need some help? Then you qualify for long-term care. In that time, yes, you say everyone you qualify for it, you could take out $120,000 a year. For how long? One, two, almost like 10 years.
Right.
And then you die, they'll only give you $10,000. But guess what? He grew up later on. And how much money did you pay?
$210,000.
You took $210,000. You take $42,000 for 5 years. That's about $200,000 plus.
Yep.
And then when you have a problem health-wise, $120,000 for 10 years. Mm-hmm. And when you die at 93, your special gets about $173,000. Mm-hmm. How much money did you pay? $210,000. $500,000 a month. So some youngsters, they understand the concept. John, I want to pay a little bit more. Can I just have a bigger benefit? Yes.
Absolutely.
Why don't you pay, same concept, same thing. You pay $250 more, $750 a month.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, it's a lot, but stop buying the stupid, goofy, iPad stuff. Why are you buying a better car? Try to save more for your retirement. But let's say you save $250 more. It sounds a lot, but that's what happened. 10 years, you invest $90,000. 20 years, $180,000. 30 years, 270,000. 35 years, 313 total that you saved. With a current rate of 7.75, actual rate for last 20 years is 8.65. 25 years, 9.03. It should be more than double anyway. Well, let's say 7.75 is only 1 million. If you die here, 1 million plus half million, 1.5 will pay to your beneficiary. You don't die, you could take out this money. So we show you here, take out about $75,000 a year. It's a good retirement package, right? Since you pay $750, more than 10 times. $75,000 a year. Now, by the time you're reaching 4 years, $60,000 minus, that means you took out more than $6,000 that you paid, which is $315,000. Until age 1991, which means about $1.6 million more than what you paid for. How much more did you pay? 300?
15.
15. $1.6 million more than that. That means almost like $2 million.
Tax-free,
yes. Tax-free is the key. And funny thing is, with this money, you could still collect the Social Security.
Yeah.
You could still collect all the benefits, because this is not your income. If you have a 401k, $75,000, you are in a big trouble.
Yes.
Medicare that you pay, like $150, you have to pay like $600-$700.
Yeah.
And also $44,000 and beyond, you have to pay 85% of your Social Security will get taxed on.
That's right.
Here, it doesn't matter. You have a 401k this much, we call it dangadang. Here, no problem, it's the best one. Now, what about long-term care? B, C, D, E, T, T, right? Long-term care, same scenario. After 5 years, which is more than, you already take out more than what you pay for.
Right.
After that, you get about $146,000 a year until next about 10 plus years. And how much money did you pay?
$350.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
It's not easy for you to save money, $500 or $750, but when you build the habit of it, this thing will change your life.
Absolutely.
You could, depending on this one. You have to worry about there will be a Social Security or not. This will definitely basically take care of you when you are healthy, when you are not that healthy.
Right.
Yep.
I know some of you Filipinos say, oh, I could have my son to come and change my diaper. Yeah, right. Please understand, we're not living in a farming industry. Your children may not even live in the same city. They may live in the same, probably not even the same country now. You want your daughter-in-law to come and change your diaper every Christmas day? Come on. Okay, so that's what we do here. Okay, so this is what we teach other people. This is what we show. And this is why you close it. So some of your licensed people, do not worry about it. You go out with flip all a couple of times with these basic things. Mm-hmm. It's easy for you to cut, you know, easy for you to close it anyway. Okay, this is our final chart, Mr. Clients. Growth, maximum 15%. Safety, minimum guarantee of 0.75, but we show you 7.75. It's not even guaranteed, but this is below average for the last 20 years. And how much money you save? You save $500 a month for 35 years, the $210,000. Now, what's the tax benefit, tax advantage? Tax deferred growth. So you will have about $641,000 by the time reaching age 65. And tax-free withdrawal, you can take about $42,000 a year for about almost like what? Until age 90-something. So total about $1 million benefits. So you could do up to $210,000 withdrawal and then using your loan for about $882,000, total about $1.1 million.
Right.
For protection insurance, you have a tax-free death. If you die, $7.5 million up to $1.1 million. But you don't die, you get a long-term care for about $1.1 million. $120,000 for almost like 10 plus years. So if you die, good! Well, it's not good, but you're okay. If you don't die, use this money, $1 million. If you got sick, use this long-term care. And how much money did you pay? You paid $210,000. Is it worth it? It is.
Yes.
Again, you know retirement crisis is coming. You know rain is coming. But don't worry about so much about it. Let's try to build the ark. Let's just build your plan. This is why you should plan. Now, you can afford it. This is why I really recommend, Mr. Clients, let's pay $250 more. With the $250, you play, it's like blackjack for 30 minutes. Philippe, yeah. Hold that, right? How much is total saving? $215. Gross, 15%. Minimum, 0.75, guaranteed. 0.75. Tax, deferred growth, until 65, it becomes about $1 million. You could take out up to $315,000 withdrawal, or beyond that, almost like $2 million money out without paying any income tax. And then protection, life insurance, $7.5 million. When you die, maximum to $1.5 million. And then when you qualify for long-term care, $146,000 for about 10 plus years. So $1.5 million long-term care. And you pay $315,000. So I really recommend you, Mr. Clients, you save probably about 10 to 20%, I'll say 15% of your income and save it here.
Right.
If you think about 2,000 minimum income, fine. Let's start with about probably about $400 or $500 and that's something. And that's how we close the deal. That's what we call it Fantastic Four to close. Very simple. And you got to have your clients start building arcs about their future. So WFG overall, I'm done, okay? Overall, we are very committed to help people out there because my life could have been changed when my mom and dad knows about this concept. Lastly, just very briefly, next 5 minutes, I want to make sure all of you, it is really 5 minutes, I got July 27th, we have a convention coming up.
Yes.
If you ever register for it, I will get you this wristband. I carry this wristband wherever I go. I come in myself. And this year, we think and grow like a future CEO. This convention, we build a CEO.
Right.
So far, I built one now in Canada, but I gotta have a couple. Don't do this to CEO by this time.
Yes.
Worst case, couple months after. Now, 4D, this is time for you to step up. If you're in a green jacket, you owe me to become a CEO. A CEO in this company make about $500,000 plus. And this is a serious deal. So this July convention is the most important one. So all of you here, members, you gotta raise for the convention. Okay, convention is a part, big part of business anyway. It's a must that you need to be a part of. Okay, so think like future CEO. And all of your leaders, what you need to focus on, just like what you're doing here. You gotta keep track who in your team is coming to blue, red and green, follow up through it. You have a May and June. Why am I here May 1st? Because it's May 1st. Because this month is very important month for all of us here. Before we go to July, you have a May and June available. May counts everything. Aside from June, we have a company Hawaii contest study for until November. Aside from July, next Super Chief will announce it. It'll be starting July through December, Marlene. So May is the time we have to prepare for it. Okay, so convention is a must. All of you register for the convention. Make sure you get ready to go. But this time, if you are going, you understand that every time we have a convention, every time we have some kind of a party going on, we call it champagne for campaign. There's a party going on. We're going to block out, we're going to rent out the whole San Pedro Square for 2,000 people. We'll rent out everything. Look at all this restaurant here. The 17, the well-known world-class restaurants out there, they're gonna serve two main dishes out there. It's all you could eat, all you could drink, all you could throw up. It's open to anybody. If you win this contest, again, you got your first 2,000. Can you imagine who brought the whole city, the square? Only nothing but WFG people.
Wow.
Okay? Now, how you qualify for it? This is a condition. This is a three ways you qualify for it. First, you win the any blue, red, and any shirts. You get two tickets until end of June. Okay? Also, when you re-qualify green jacket, you get the two tickets. Now, some of you are brand new. This is what I want you to do. You do minimum 210, and month of May, one ticket. Month of June again, two tickets. So Marlene, you could qualify for yourself and be qualified again for your one of your teammates or your spouse. Okay? So some of you go, John, what about I make the shirts? I become a green jacket again, I do 210, doesn't matter, maximum two tickets in. Which is you all allowed to have only one wife. Come on. Okay, but can you imagine? We're gonna take on the whole city pretty much. Okay, that's what's going on out there. And when you have a convention now, every time convention, there's a big recreation going on. This time, we're gonna come up with a book with your picture on it. Whoever qualifies for any kind of shirts, with the blue shirts, and I'll show you a little bit more different one, but they'll see your pictures here, with the black, red, and everything. Don't tell me how good you are. People will see that. So what you mean is, you have the May and June, 2 months to qualify for it. But I know for a fact, anybody fight for it, you can qualify for it anyway. And also, we have another book coming out called Giant Level. Level 1, Level 2, and all that. We got also pictures for you and your teammates too. John, what's the Level 1, 2? Here, let's write this one. Level 1, 2, 3. Start with the personal base shop. Personal team. 210 is your two recruit 10,000 points on your pen, personal. You level one. That's how you get a one ticket. I know some of you are here for the webinar. Our head coach screamed at us and me. Don't talk about the small one. Talk about something a lot bigger. Which means everybody should do minimum 30,000 plus. Everybody should do minimum probably 500 plus. But level one, two, three, personal. And this is the key. When you do any kind of level, we'll show us here. So when you go to convention, they're gonna come with a big book with the pictures. Okay? Don't tell me, don't how good you are. You'll be a picture of the CEO, but I want you to win this one too. That's what it is. Okay? And look at this, look at the same thing, but level one, two, three. If you do 210, your base shot does here, and 10 and 30,000, that's how you create momentum. But if you do that, you make about 150,000 every year. Mm-hmm. How long you take for you to build a team like this? If you're really coming for the next about 2-3 months, you could build this. I guarantee you're gonna make 150,000. How long will it take for you to make 150,000 from your stupid job?
Right.
Do you even have a chance? Here? 2-3 months, Jeremy. That's why I said come back here, build a team now. This is the perfect time, man. If you could build a little bit bigger with a 50,000 point, that's a quarter million.
Yeah.
How long will it take? Probably 2-3 months later, after you do this, probably next month. And then you go to next month, I'll have to show it to you, you make about half a million.
Yes.
It may take you another 2-3 months from here, but which means next about 6 months to 1 year, if you're really focusing on, you could literally change your life. Can you imagine you have a chance to make what happened?
Yes.
Yeah. And this goofy young man moved from California to here, I don't think he never think about making income that he's gonna make. But guess what? It could happen. Mm-hmm. It did happen. So I want you to really fight for this one. And this is our, this is my last page.
Okay.
This is how you get the blue shirts. Okay, let me show you this one. This is easy. So first month and second month, you do 10-10. So which means 2 months, you do 20 recruits, you qualify for blue shirts. Anybody wearing a blue shirt? Nobody? Okay. And after that, you do 15-15, which is 30 recruits in 2 months, then you do red. Who's wearing red? Stand up, look at them. Take up your jacket. Look at them. That's a shirt.
Wow.
Can you imagine that goofy looking boy? Used to be a surgeon in Philippines. Okay, he's just helping people who support. Right, support. Anyway, with the red shirts, he looks really sexy here. The bad thing is now, which means first month you do 10, second month you do 20. You qualify for red? Yes, you qualify for red. They could be 2 months combined together. 30-30 is green, 50-50 yellow, 75-700. By the time you reach 100, that's time you're fighting for your CEO. I don't want you to be a CEO. I want you to be 100 and CEO. And now I see some problem here. Some people hit 10-10, get the blue, 15-15, get the red, but they don't maintain 15 plus, something is wrong. You know what's the problem? You got 10 recruits. Next month, you should have more than 10. Next month, you got to have more than 15. Finally, was more than 15. Only reason you're not growing that way is, which means you don't understand the importance of meeting. When you have a 10 recruits, Marlene, have a 10 recruit come to meeting like this consistently twice a week. You don't come to meeting twice a week, you're not in this business here. You have a meeting here on Tuesday and Saturday. LA, my office, Tuesday and Saturday. You don't come twice a week, you're not part of the meeting. You're not part of the business here. When you have 10 people, all 10 people come twice a week, I guarantee you're gonna move to 30 right away.
Yeah.
I see some people, you know, 15-15, get the red. But next month, it went down to 5. What's going on? Nobody come to meeting. Mm-hmm. And I said, oh my gosh, you're missing big in the duplication business here.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to be here. I know Philip duplicate me. Sometimes he does a lot better than me. Why? That's part of business. It took me for a while for me to duplicate myself to him, but it happened. And what's the best way? Meeting. Best way is convention. I'm really done. I know you got it.
Just five more minutes.
That's right. Just 2 minutes. One thing that I don't understand, the 26 years in this industry, very simple. If you could just do exactly what I ask you to do in the next 3 months, your life could have been changed. Which means if somebody said, John, I made my decision. Tell me, show me what to do. Next 9 days, I'll do whatever it takes. I guarantee you, you're going to get into this level. And you're going to make probably minimum quarter million plus on that moment and all. If you really commit for next 1 year after this one, you have a chance to see yourself making $1 million in 2019. And that's why you need to go to convention. You gotta make that decision. And funny thing is, people cannot. Biggest mistake that I made last 25 years, 26 years, man, this guy is good looking. I mean, little bit chubby, but it's kind of cute.
Yeah.
If this guy, I mean, he could be, you know, so what I did last 25 years, I tried to change this guy. I throw some contests. I buy him a dinner. We drink the beer together. We spend the time together, try to shape up his mindset. And guess what? It cannot work unless he makes his own decision.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what's the best way for me to do? I have to bring him to the place, to the environment. Hopefully he can make his own decision, which is convention.
Right.
Las Vegas convention is not a joke. Jeremy Merlin, tonight before you go, register for it. I want you to go. Also make sure this event, twice a week in office, it is also a decision-making process. Just come. It doesn't matter, raining, snowing, thunder, doesn't matter, I want you to come. Only three exceptions. If you're dying, don't come. Your direct family has some emergency, you gotta be there to support them, be there. Your family is very important too. Okay, number three, yeah, I'm not sure here, but in California, we have earthquake. In the LA, you guys have earthquake too?
No.
No?
No.
In my case, you only have a two. In California, I give one more exception. If you have a more than 8.0 scale plus earthquake, don't come. It could be dangerous. But Vegas, you only have a two. If you die, don't come. If your family die, don't come. Or else just come to event. Because why? When you come to twice doing meeting, I'll show you how to make $1 million here. If you really make a commitment decision, I'll do whatever it takes to make it happen, 3 months, your life will be changed. Or, if you think about buying this restaurant, you invest your lifetime saving. You are the owner who has a kid. Your restaurant open at 7 o'clock on Thursday night, Tuesday night. All the leaders now, listen to me. You are the one who owns this restaurant. You are the one with the kid. Okay, 4D, don't. 7 o'clock, Tuesday, your restaurant open. If I'm a cashier, I could show up at 7:15. But you are the one with the kid. What time would you show up? What time would you open this restaurant for your employee or your client?
7 o'clock,
you come at 7, you're danga. You should come at least an hour before, and your team, you should get ready for your team every Tuesday night and every Saturday morning. Why? That's our business hours. In my area, there's a couple of different dry cleaning stores. My wife asked me to pick it up in the morning, so I went to about early in the morning, around 6:30.